This was in response to queries raised in the June 2021 Auditor General's report that highlighted that over the years, the Ministry of Defence and Veteran Affairs accumulated arrears arising from court awards and compensation and other liabilities, with the figure at the time of audit totaling to 2.470 billion shillings as of June 2021.
In relation to cases of damage or injury,
where the Attorney General is sued, loses, yes, and refers to the parent, to the tortfeasor.
Yes, Chair.
Francis Ngabiano, the Undersecretary Logistics at the Ministry of Defence and Veteran Affairs, informed the committee that the Ministry of Defence inherited a stock of compensation and court awards following the decentralisation of this item to the ministries, departments and agencies without the corresponding funding allocation, thus putting the stock of verified court awards and compensation arrears close to 2.47 billion shillings.
The stock of verified court awards and compensation arrears at close of financial 2020-2021 was 2.4 billion.
The committee chairperson, Medad Segona, MP Busiro East, questioned why taxpayers should continue meeting the cost of compensating Ugandans who are victims of torture and other human rights violations at the hands of soldiers instead of having the individual soldier pay compensation.
How do we get to this situation where you're compelled to use our money to pay damages for the people whose rights you violate?
Any offense committed in the course of duty, because I may be driving genuinely a truck, it fails to brake, it enters somebody's property or house, you run over people inside that house, you're paying for the house, you're paying for the people, so that's an accident.
In response, Joint Chief of Staff informed Parliament that some of the reports about the army brutality are exaggerated by media that majorly focuses on the army's wrongs instead of rights, to the extent that some of the incidents, when they occur, the army does not have an opportunity to know how they started, but assured Ugandans of UPDF plans to deal with all soldiers that cross that line.
Actually, the numbers that were given were bigger. And when verification was done, we found that the numbers were less.
Not only have court awards and compensations continued to accumulate over the years, also domestic arrears have accrued to 364.8 billion shillings. Although the stock of arrears for pension and gratuity have been reducing in the last 3 years from 508.6 billion shillings in 2019 to 84.86 billion in 2021, domestic arrears for goods and services have increased from 141 billion in 2019 to 279 billion in 2021.
That after this COVID-19 pandemic, as much as possible, suppliers should be paid, because we are aware that some of the businesses have collapsed. Some people borrow to actually supply.
The Public Accounts Committee has also queried UPDF over expenditure of 2.8 trillion shillings that was spent on unquantified outputs and activities.
We can still detail the Auditor General to go back, sit down with you, and confirm to us that there is quantification.
The UPDF was also quizzed on irregular compensation of 1.8 billion shillings for Kibanja land situated in Chihumra village in Kabale district. The 1.8 billion shillings was part of the 3.5 billion shillings which was paid out without original copy of documents of proof.
1.8 acres can cost 3 billion shillings.
No.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.